There we go. Would you like me to hit do the recap, or does somebody want to take it over?
There's a couple things I can remember, but I can't remember all of them.
Okay, yeah, go lay it on us and I'll fill in the blanks.
All right, so after the night were there was like a power surge in the city. We're trying to figure out where that was coming from. After I charged my equipment back up, and we left the little scat or Scrapper Island thing. We traveled south and we met up with a, I can't remember what he was, a shady individual, shall we say, who was trying to buy some dogs. And the guy wasn't buying them. And then me and Malachi kind of figured out something weird was going on with the dogs. And we end up following that individual to a bar. Conversations were had because he was trying to do business proposals of buying weapons. He's basically a arms dealer as well. He's a man of many means, we'll say. As we were leaving, there was an explosion and we almost all died.
That is a very good recollection. So it was through some skill checks, it was determined that the death of the puppies had a direct correlation to the energy surge stuff that happened at midnight. That the dogs' eardrums were blown, which led to their death. Which led y'all to believe that obviously there was some kind of high-pitched noise that humans could not hear, that it was something only dogs could hear. So yeah, there you all wrapped up your business dealings, stepped outside of the tavern there. You saw a chronicler outside, kind of in the streets, looking around, who suddenly hollers out at you, to watch out. Right as he does so, there was a giant explosion, shit hits the fan, and that's where we are. So, 1 second. Was loud as shit. Okay. Yeah, so nobody was successful. This was just outright killed. That's what we're going with. You also noticed that as y'all were trying to move around and gather yourselves, you were hearing, pop, 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 pop noises and seeing the dust fly up around you, which indicated that whoever was shooting at you has a silencer equipped. So Frayne kind of comes crawling over to you as well as the chronicler, and like, guys, we've got to get the fuck out of here. Does anybody know where? Is there any place that we can go? While this is going on, why doesn't everybody give me an instinct perception roll, please? Don't forget that if you have trauma, that each point of trauma deducts a dice from your roll.
I got a quick question for you.
Yep.
Did you record my flesh wounds after last session? I'm only showing that I'm two down, but I don't think that's correct.
Nope, that's correct. So you're actually 12 down. You have 2 flesh wounds remaining, and then you go into trauma.
Okay. Yeah. So I misread that the other way around. Okay. Yep. All right.
Same thing with you, Brent. If you look, your flesh wounds, your maximum is 14. You currently have 12. So once that number reaches 14, then you start getting into your trauma, which is really bad.
Once it reaches, okay.
And then Amon, you obviously know what's going on. All right, so you all, you know, dodging in and out of the hail of bullets, you do kind of pick up that the main concentration of the bullets seems to be concentrated on Pi. Pi, you have the stuff. Don't. What's that?
The chronicler suit on.
Say that again. I'm sorry.
The chronicler suit.
The whoever's shooting at you mainly seems to be shooting at you.
Well, because you've got he's got the discs, right?
Yeah. I don't know how they found out, but they did, I guess.
So,
you're physically carrying them, though, right?
Yes, very much so.
So the chronicler hits a couple buttons on a suit, and then Pi, the familiar green lights that you know that you use often, kind of shoot out into the alleyway and out towards the attacker, creating kind of a distraction. About that time, you hear a clink, 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 clink. And everybody's hair on the back of their neck starts to stand up as all the batteries on your suit and the other chronicler suit are suddenly drained.
Son of a bitch!
So Frayne kind of motions for y'all to duck and haul ass down the alleyway if y'all want to follow him.
I'm on his tail.
I mean,
we have a choice.
Choice at this point in time.
Yep, no choice.
All right, so you make your way into the alleyway. About that time, you see a figure kind of post up at the other end as he kind of leans around and fires a couple more shots down towards y'all, and then kind of takes cover back around the corner. So now why don't y'all give me a sight cunning roll, please? All right. Just waiting. Well, there's no need to. So with that, you all see that there is a kind of a recessed door that you might be able to bust through to get out of the alleyway and go and take some cover inside. I'm guessing y'all probably want to duck in and do that.
I mean, sounds like
a plan. Yeah, I'll throw a shoulder into it.
All right, yep. So Twister, you throw your shoulder. Everybody starts going inside. The chronicler on his way in ends up taking a round in the shoulder and kind of stumbles a little bit, and so Frayne helps him out.
I help pull him in.
All right. That is one of your compadres.
Let's put that door back in place and try to bar it if it's possible. And then see what our surroundings are.
So let's see here. So now that y'all have kind of ducked around in the building a little bit, taking a little bit of cover, why don't y'all give me an intellect legends roll, please? And chroniclers,
oh yeah.
Pi, you can add your secrets traits to the roll. All the dice, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Crit, or whatever, I can't remember what the hell it's called.
All right, so you all kind of pick up on what you already know, that the person attacking you is a paler, and he appears to be after whatever Pi happens to be carrying, which you all kind of figured out already was the artifacts. He is extremely skilled, extremely accurate, and extremely deadly, which means he's a very high-ranking person within the cult. And he might even be as high-ranking as a Halo, which, if I remember right, was pretty high up there. I'm actually going to look at that real quick.
Doesn't sound like somebody we're going to take on. So I think we're going to have to figure out a way to get out of here.
I second that.
All right, so give me one second here.
What do you guys think? Should we, like, get out of here and try to get back to the island?
I think first we need to assess what's going on outside. That could be all but impossible right now. I would assume with the bomb going off in this area, there's probably a very heavy police presence, and I'm sure there's also people we don't want to be dealing with all around, too.
Sure.
So a Halo is rank 4 within the Paler cult, and there is only one rank higher than him, and that is a demigod. So it's, yeah.
Well, they're throwing the big wigs at us, boys and girls.
It's,
who would know, just I'm more throwing this out to the two older people in the party, but who all knows that they have those discs or whatever they are?
They seem to pinpoint right in on.
They might on Pi, yeah, on Pi. That's what I'm getting at. Like, who they all knows about
it? On the frequency, possibly, is what I'm going to assume for now.
So if we can't mask that, whatever it is that they're detecting, then they're going to find us wherever we go.
That's what I'm getting at. And refresh my memory real quick. What is it exactly that you're carrying, Pi?
It is a piece that will lead to a way to fix the.
The internet.
It's like one of four. Yeah, like one of four pieces, right? And we have a couple
of
pieces.
And we have.
Okay, and we have two.
We only need one more.
I gotcha. And I take it one of them is like a radio, like it's sending out a radio frequency.
They vibrate at a frequency.
Okay, I gotcha. All right.
Especially when they are closer, they will kind of give off more of a pulse, I guess you could say.
Closer to each other, or closer?
Closer
in general?
To each other.
How,
at this point, I'm going to check and see if it feels like the piece might be any closer than it was before.
It does not. So you know that the three pieces are the disc, the star, and the spear of Jahamid, is the names of them. You currently have the disc and the star. So Frayn kind of, with Pi helping the chronicler through, the house, like you come out on a parallel street, your attacker does not appear to be behind you. When you come out, you see a squad of guards, coming your direction. So Frayn, grabs, Twister by the shoulder and says, the Anabaptists, they will only slow us down. Twister, you weren't here, so you won't remember, but remember the agreement. And he hands you his pistol and says, you take the chronicler, get yourself to safety, and I'll distract the guards, and we'll meet after sunset at the West Wind.
Okay, sure. Yeah, okay. I'll take it. And let him make his move, and then once they seem like they're going after him, I'll move in the direction that they were coming from with this injured person.
All right, so Frayn starts heading towards the guards. Hey, over here, it was a gas explosion. Oh my God, help me, I'm wounded. And he starts, he turns it on, putting on a show. The chronicler says, I have a shed down in the Furs quarter. If we get there quick, we can take the stairs down to the jetties and we can hide out there.
What do you guys think? You coming?
Yep, right behind you.
I'm helping him, if he's having trouble walking, I'm helping him out. We're getting out of here.
I'm going to pay special attention to watching our six to make sure that we're not being followed.
All right, give me a perception roll for that then. All right. So yeah, you keep an eye, and you both can't pick up on anybody following you. Your tracks look to be covered for now. And by the way, just a quick little note: I went through and I've been resizing and redoing the maps in this. So if the map doesn't work for you, let me know and I'll reshare it.
Yeah, I was trying to bring up the map for this place and it was like,
Okay, yeah, let me do that real quick so we can re-bookmark them.
Me too.
Yeah, I've been doing them so that I've been, instead of PNGs, using JPEG so they're not as big.
Oh, but PNGs have the better quality.
They do. Second. Right there is the town. Here is the area map. There is the island. Yeah, I think that is all of them. If you come across one that doesn't open up, let me know. All right, so the chronicler guides you down to where his little shack is. See if it's actually on the map here. No, it doesn't look like it's on the map at all. So, yeah. So he stops you at a little shithole of a place, does some stuff to the cylinder cipher lock on the door, and then it opens up inside to his hut. Inside, the light kind of neon, it comes on, illuminating a little bit. And he says, Ampere, that's my name. What are y'all's?
Tell him my name.
I'm Twister. I'm Malachi.
Known as Pie.
A Manator and Pie.
Meowty.
He opens up the collar to his chronicler suit and he kind of works his shoulder a little bit, and he's like, "Are you able to treat my wound for me?"
Anybody? What was his name again, real quick?
Ampere.
I look to the others. I am not well versed in medical. Are either of you at all?
Got some rudimentary skills, but
I
don't know if it's gonna help.
5 dice in it. I need tools to do it
too, but I don't like have any equipment or anything.
No, I mean you could try to check him out, Amon. Why don't you give me an intellect medicine roll?
He's gonna die.
1 success. That is all that you needed, and you got it. So you kind of take his shoulder, move it around a little bit, and you see that it is barely a scratch. That he's perfectly fine.
Hands it. He just wanted to get close to you, Monitor.
That's right. It was a trick. It's a trap. So he thanks you, and lets out a big long sigh and fixes his suit back up. And that was exciting. What in the hell was that all about?
I am unaware of what was going on. Why were you out there, and why did you know? Why did you warn us? You seemed to know what was going on.
Second here. Wow, this is a really big workshop. We don't need half of this stuff. Not going to turn around a little music though. There we go. All right. So he says, last night there were fluctuations of currents throughout the city. It was a near field that triggered by a magnetic pulse that. At noon, I tried to triangulate the origin of the field, but it isn't stationary. The antenna of it appears to be moving. And he jumps up to his feet and begins to go over to the wall and start taking notes and writing stuff on there. I think something powerful might be haunting Breast. It doesn't appear to be the paler from earlier. Although I don't know how he fits into the scheme of things, but his equipment, it has no comparable signature of anything. He jumps over towards the window, kind of peeking out. You know, he didn't follow us or anything, did he? The only logical conclusion is that Marauder has a finger in the pie. It must be our guy.
What's our guy?
Gent. So I looked him up on the... on the actual website, because he's not in this book, and he, if I remember right, is some kind of like god almost among certain type of people. So he takes a seat back down. And continues on his story.
Do I notice anything in the writings that kind of jumps out at me, or no?
It appears you can tell that he's been taking notes of something, some of which he is getting ready to elaborate on a little bit. He says, last year in Borca, a a squad of Preservists wiped out a group of Pictons who had invaded the Western Protectorate. They are Argai's slave warriors. My job there was to crack the conditioning of the captured Pictons. The warriors were calibrated, brainwashed. So I interrogated them, and it yielded the same thing over and over. Disc, star, spear. I examined them further, and one name came out. Helios. So why don't y'all give me a Legends roll?
And there's always one extra six in there, essentially. Just for not a success, but the extra achievement bull honky. So the four is a six or something.
Alright, so he is like a servant of that guy Argyre, a sleeper prophet. And that's more will end up coming to fruition of that. I don't want to spoil anything.
So Helios is a agent of Argyre?
Yes.
Alright. Does everybody know that, or do I need to like tell them that?
Basically? Everybody's kind of, you've heard just in your travelings, you've heard the stories and stuff like that.
What do I know of Argyre? I don't really know much about him.
Nobody really knows anything about him.
So we kind of know more about Helios than we do actually Argyre.
Yeah. Ampere kind of carries on a little bit. The data that we found on Helios in the cluster revealed him to be a sleeper prophet. He has palers. They seem to just obey him. And their agenda does not seem to align with other, sleepers and palers. And he kind of walking alongside of his notes, going over the different reports. I placed a query in the static stream to find clues about the conditioning of the Pictons. And in 2588, there was a radio message from Eastern Borka. From one tower to another, they were discussing some kind of artifact that they referred to as Jahamad's Will. It's seemed to have three parts, a disc, a star, and a spear. But it gets even better than this. 2588 and 2597 both yield the same numerical anagram, 1616.
2588 and 2597.
This code, it's been appearing on switch profiles in the Aquitaine cluster for weeks now. I pleaded with the cluster, you know, to help me investigate this, but I got nothing out of them. I requested a special unit. Nobody showed up. Maybe their cover was blown. Maybe somebody intercepted my messages. I just have no idea. For all I know, the cluster's been infiltrated. Maybe somebody's trying to get rid of me because I know too much. Everything's just totally fucked. Nothing seems to be right. The paler, he's got to be after me. I need some allies to help me find out what's going on here. And he kind of looks to Malachi. You check out the window and make sure everything's okay, please. I mean, you never know. We could have been followed.
Yeah, I'll take a look.
All right, give me a perception roll again.
Uh,
All right. So he kind of takes a break from his ramblings for a minute to kind of let what he's been talking about sit in.
I just kind of watch him constantly, looking for... He just seems off. Like he's been kind of strung out almost.
Yeah, you can definitely tell that whatever his... You know how if you've been obsessing about something for so long, it envelops you. That's all that you know. So you can definitely kind of pick up on that a little bit, that he is obsessed with whatever is going on here. So Malachi, you look out the window. And you see that dusk appears to be kind of engulfing the town a little bit. Does anybody want to use this opportunity to heal up?
I would love to try and heal up.
Yeah, me too.
Right.
I'm not super good at it though. I can throw 5 dice and that's it.
I'm only showing 2 points of damage from a bar fight, but that's been a while ago. I don't know if I got anything from...
No, your 12 is your damage. That means you've got 12 hit points of damage.
Oh, so you had 2 from... Oh, yeah, 2 points from... Already. Oh, shit. So you are... I'd miss that. You're almost at 14 two. Flesh wounds, so you're pretty fucked up right now.
Yeah.
We're all pretty fucked up.
Yeah, you're all pretty fucked up. Just Twister's especially fucked up.
Where are my points? I don't see that.
So if you look on your character sheet, you got flesh under conditions. You've got flesh wounds 14. And then in the bar or in the square to the right of it, it says 14 there. That is how many flesh wounds you've taken. So now your damage you take will go into the trauma area. And for each point of trauma, that reduces one of the dice that you would roll to do something. And then when you hit 8 trauma, you die.
Yeah, I don't want to get there.
But let me get...
It's really easy to die, let me tell you.
Yeah. Let me get to the healing, which I think is in the bazaar. Nope, it was under battle. Under wounds. Regeneration. That's ego points. Healing. There we go. With medicine, you can aid nature to heal flesh wounds right after battle. You roll intellect medicine to heal 1 plus trigger wounds. That can be done once.
That's once per day, correct? Or something like that?
Correct.
Who's failing Locky?
So you... 1 plus trigger. So you heal 2, Twister. So what you would do is change your 14 there in the box to a 12.
I'll work on myself.
Pi, 1, 2, 3, 4. The Twister, I told you
the sixes, right?
I told you correct, so, or I told you incorrect, but we'll just roll with what you got. So Pi, you need the check you have to get is 2 successes, and you heal 1 plus your trigger. So you definitely got that. So you heal a total of 3.
Hey.
Amon, 1, 2, you heal 1 flesh wound. Malachi, 1, 2, you heal 1 flesh wound as well.
And you say I can do this once or like once,
per day? Once per day. And then also whenever you sleep, you heal 1 flesh wound as well.
Cool. Okay. I'm gonna lay down on this guy's city mattress and see if I can catch some sleep.
And the way, so if you start getting into your trauma, you cannot heal your trauma until all of your flesh wounds are healed. So it can, it's bad news when you start getting into your trauma.
Yeah, I understand that.
It takes forever, because you can only get one trauma like a month.
Or you can go under the knife, which...
and hopefully not get killed.
Yeah, and hopefully not get killed. Although the last surgeon got ate by a crocodile, so hopefully that doesn't... That lessens your chance. Alright, so... with dusk kind of closing in... you look out, and Malachi, you notice a familiar face out in the crowd there.
Who's that?
And she appears to be talking to somebody at a stall there. Just kind of across the way a little bit. Do you remember her?
I do not. Vaguely, but not exactly who she is.
She was on that island, the Scrapper Island, number 18, with the ladies' man.
Yeah, she was out there with Perel, got pissed off that y'all were there. She looked a little sick and stormed off.
Oh, yeah. Does she look better now?
From what you can tell, she does not. She looks a little worse.
She's got the tetanus.
And didn't we give her some antidotes or some, or try to help her?
No. She stormed out.
That's right. Yeah. I got you. I remember that.
You're the only one that knows she's there.
Well, I'm going to tell everybody else, of course.
I kind of look it over at Amp here. Well, we could hide possibly over on the Scrapper Island. It might be a little safer, Amp here, than your current abode. Be right back. I kind of edge my way over to the door and open it up and... Garlene!
So she ignores you, or perhaps just does not hear you. One second. While I...
This is where Pi gets shot. Dies now.
That would never happen, ever.
Uh-huh. You guys smell that?
Ooh, it's getting pretty deep in here. To find just some good music here to proceed. That's the problem. Most of their ambient music is all like for D&D stuff.
This is why I miss having bots for Discord.
Yeah.
I can just play something on YouTube and be good.
Yeah, and I mean, the YouTube channel that I listen to is absolutely amazing. We're just going to roll with what the fuck's playing now. So yeah, you holler out at her, and she's either ignoring you or doesn't hear you. She seems to be in some kind of heated discussion with the person whose booth that she is at.
I sigh and slide out the door. And
yeah, I'm gonna go too.
All right, Amon and Twister, y'all stand back.
I'll go with him.
I'm gonna stay on that bed and try to rest.
All right. So as you approach, you hear, you know, saying, "Of course I can work. I've been working hard my whole life. No, I'm not. I'm not sick. It's just the flu, Furrier. There's no reason to worry. I can sew. I can stretch and skin. You know, no matter what you give me, I can do it well." The guy kind of points at her arm and just, "What's wrong with your arm, Scrapper? What, does it have the flu too or something?" She kind of looks around and then catches y'all out in the corner of her eye, and you see her kind of roll her eyes a little bit. "Ugh, that's just fucking great. You guys are exactly who I wanted to see. What's wrong? Did Perel send you to come beg me to come back to his workshop? Forget it. I'm not going back to that fucking island. That horny prick can go find him another helper."
"Well, no, I was seeing if you needed assistance. But if you don't need assistance or potentially a job, that's fine. We'll go about our own business. We know scrappers such as yourself, or individuals such as yourself, are quite handy. And if this gentleman doesn't want you for work or anything, well, that's fine. You continue to have your argument."
So, Pi, Malachi, and Amon, give me instinct perception rules, please.
Come on with the rolls.
I don't see anything at all. Let's go.
Two, and look at Amon there. Goodness gracious.
Eagle eyes.
I see that. So,
ever vigilant.
So Malachi and Amon, you notice something a little weird. The fur's son, which is the guy that's running the booth, looks to be maybe 14, 15, 16, somewhere in there, is extremely pale, and is kind of ducking behind his father a little bit, kind of like hiding out of view. His eyes are red, and he's just kind of staring up at Garlene, just like he's never seen a woman before. What in the, oh my god, it's beautiful.
It's a goddess.
So Garlene's like, "You know, Perel is, he's a fool with all the different idiots and stuff that he just surrounds himself with."
Just kind of pull out this beeping device and look at it curiously. I can't remember what it was.
So, you see that the source of the beeping, like a little pin, appears to be coming about 300 meters from the south. While you're looking at this, you suddenly begin to hear this, this throaty growling noise. Suddenly the fur son jumps over the workbench, and like tackles Garlene to the ground and begins like biting at her arm. She begins yelling in pain. "What the fuck is going on here? Oh my god!" And the fur is just sitting there hollering at him. "Elam, what are you doing? What the fuck?"
Monitor, help me get him off there.
All right.
I try to is pull like him off with zombie? Monitor's help.
Yeah, I'll pull him off.
Let's see here. One second.
I'm actively watching our back from all directions.
So
I know he's not very visually perceptive, so he's not going to be the lookout man.
So why don't y'all give me Amon and Pi? Give me. We're gonna go with some body brawl rolls.
Not force.
Well, force is as if you're wanting to. Are you trying? Are you like gonna punch him the fuck out and knock him off?
No, or I was
you...
just trying to force him off. That come out wrong. I regret that.
All right. all right. So you both kind of tangle him up a little bit, and he seems to be just, you know, almost. I don't want to say inhumanly strong, but he's definitely trying to get at her with some kind of purpose. And she is obviously, you know, hollering at him and shit. And suddenly there's some rustling behind you that Malachi, you spot two figures are coming at you with their mouths open. With one of them's got an iron bar and the other one has a knife. So we're gonna do some combat here.
Son of a bitch.
One second, let me get to the page where these people are at. Shit.
Let me know if I can hear any of this going on outside.
Oh, you're gonna hear something really soon. It's gonna be gunfire.
So you're gonna hear 357 Magnum going off in about 2 seconds.
I got me a revolver.
So give me 1 second. I apparently my oh no, never mind. There's my writing utensil. Let's see here. This is fine. Just making sure I got everything real quick. All right, so let's do some. It is a shit. I don't even remember what it is that we roll for combat. Help me out here, somebody.
Oh, it's instinct reaction or something, isn't it?
Psych reaction.
Yes. Let's roll some psych reaction there. Malachi, Amon, and Pi. And Twister, don't worry. We will get to you momentarily. So Amon has 1, 2, 3, 4 successes.
I wanted triggers.
Pi has 1, 2, 3, 4 successes. Malachi has 1, 2 successes with 1 trigger. Let me roll for the other two guys real quick.
I don't like it when you roll for them because you roll too good.
So there's 2. And the other one. Is going last.
You're not gonna roll for the kid?
Negative. He is kind of a non-combatant.
Okay. Because the first thing that was gonna come out of Pi's mouth was, you better get your kid or I'm gonna put him down for you.
Ooh, I like the name of this. Electric Hell. Will it live up to the name? All right, here we go. So Amon, you are up first. We're gonna call them number one and number two. They are out of melee range, but they are, I think you can move up to 2 meters without taking your penalty, so they are within that 2 meters. So Amon and Pi, you are both up first.
And it's just two guys against us?
Yep, two guys against each of you.
I'll attack.
All right, you gonna shoot at one of them?
Yeah.
All right, so let's go ahead and give me your shoot and roll.
One sec, agile.
Agility projectiles, I believe.
And I have salvos on my gun, which is, I wrote down that it's +3.
All right. All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4 successes with 2 triggers. And if I remember right, something, you get some bonuses or something if there's some extra triggers, if I remember.
Smooth running, it should say how many triggers it needs.
Yeah, I think.
And that adds in another round of firing.
You get another round with -2 dice. And the amount of smooth running that I need is I didn't write that down. Hold on, let me pull out the book real quick.
While she's looking that up, Pi, so we're gonna say she's shooting at number one. Pi, are you gonna shoot at number two or shoot at the same one?
Kind of hoping to wait and see if it went down and then shoot the other one, or shoot the same one.
Well, y'all are attacking at the same time.
I know. I will be ballsy and shoot the other one, I guess.
All right, let's do it then. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. That's definitely going to hit, and you got 2 triggers in there.
And I need to know the smooth running because I'm also.
I don't the same exact see. Same thing. See, assault rifle.
Let me
I'm
see
looking
here.
At it in the thing. It says distance 3120, damage 11, 30 mags, 3 salvos, tech 4, slots 1. Like, I don't see anything about that. Triggers, but I know I've seen it somewhere.
Yeah, give me 1 second. I am checking the. It's not in battle, it's in bazaar. It is in weapon qualities. Salvos. There we go. This gives in the salvos quality. The shooter can fire several bullets in rapid succession and thus in one action. Every bullet increases the handling by +1 dice and the damage by 1. If it's hit several targets together, yada, 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 yada. Smooth running. A perfect weapon for attacks in rapid succession. If the fighter reaches at least the stated number of triggers within their attack roll, he may attack again right afterwards with a penalty of -2 dice. It can happen over and over and over, but obviously each time... the penalty goes up by 2 dice.
Yeah, where's the trigger though?
Here.
I took a screenshot of all this information. And I see nothing.
The it trigger had it should for the be in. Gun. It says smooth running. And mine has smooth running. Parentheses T. 2T parentheses.
I don't think I get trigger. I get salvos. I don't get smooth running on the assault
rifle. Yeah, the assault rifle doesn't have smooth running.
I have the smooth running.
Okay, all right.
All right, so you took 3, you said 3 salvos, wasn't that right, Adrana?
Yeah, so it says every bullet increases the handling by +1 dice, so I added 3 to my my attack and the damage by one, so I have plus three damage. So that means 14 damage total. Right. If several targets are close together and the shooter wants to move the weapon, he splits his attack evenly between the targets.
So would you like to do that?
Yeah, seven damage each.
All right.
Actually, I don't know. What do you...
I'm just going to light up one target.
Let me just shoot the guy on the right. Shoot the guy on the...
Shooting the opposite one, and I hit him twice, I'm going to assume.
All right. So I do want...
I'm running right into him, and I do 14 damage. Or 13, sorry, because 17.
I do want to look at the ammo tables real quick. Nope, that's armor, not ammo. Ammo types. 11. Huh, that's... I'm curious about that. So the 5.56 is 11 damage. So I wonder if that's per bullet or per clip. I don't know. Who fucking cares? All right. So
it won't be per magazine because there's 30 rounds in a magazine.
Yeah. All right. So you, Amon, you level and just unload on the number one approaching and just shred. Just blowing him back the way he's coming in. He just falls into a mutilated hump. Or just, he's fucked. He's dead.
So I use three bullets in that one shot, I think is what salvos means, right?
I don't know. We'll figure that out later.
Okay, I'm trying to...
Yeah, I never...
I know you said you wanted to keep... I'm going to mark that I used three, and I now have 27.
Yeah, that's... I need to ask them about that in the Discord. You know, how exactly does the bullets work? But... all right, and Pi, you were firing 14. Off the same thing, correct?
14. Altogether, because I did two shots.
All right, so yeah, you just totally annihilate the guy... the other guy that was coming at you. So that happens. That happens. Malachi, you just... end up standing there with looking at them as they just mowed them down. Twister, give me a perception roll, please. All right, so you don't hear anything. However... the guy who you're staying with in there, kind of like, hey, your guys are out there fighting. Your guys are out there fighting.
All right, I'm going to drag my ass off this mattress and go to the door and crack it open and see what the fuck's going on.
All right, so you see, right as you crack the door, you see Amon and Pi level their weapons down and just... annihilate two guys that were coming at him.
I'm going to stand there and observe for a moment and see if there's more people coming. Maybe I can be a surprise attack if somebody's coming they don't see.
All right. So let's see here. So you also see, Pi, you notice that the beeping is getting closer and louder on this little device.
Shit.
And you suddenly see this person.
We need to go, and we do need to go now. I think I know how they're tracking us.
Moving through the stalls. You remember who she is?
Oh, it's that chick again. Damn it.
That's that crazy bitch that...
Nice. We got her mask.
Right, and she didn't have any breasts.
I can't remember who took her mask, but we got it.
Let me see here. I am trying to...
Is somebody... Somebody followed her, and then she took off her mask, dove in the water.
Yeah, that was me.
Yeah, so you have her mask.
No, I didn't have her mask. Somebody.
Yeah, he never picked it up.
Somebody did.
I don't remember that anybody did. I'd have to go back and watch the VOD. see. But nonetheless, she...
Yeah, I'm pretty sure somebody picked it up, too. Pretty sure somebody picked it up.
I will make a note of that.
Might have been Viz.
Or... And if it is Viz, then...
It's laying in the street. Somewhere.
I should have looted it.
Yeah, no, we were kind of running for our lives. So.
Yeah, we didn't have time for that.
The scrappers would have loved his body because he had rounds for stuff.
So you hear her voice kind of resonate through the area. Devour her. She carries the new life within her. Tear her skin off in scraps. As she's kind of darting in and out of the stalls in the area. And you... What do y'all want to do?
Are we still in initiative?
Or? No. Though at the moment you are not.
Is anyone responding to her calls?
Or are there people you do hear commotion off in the distance. Like maybe there are people that are responding to this. And as she's moving about, Pi, you see the blip on this little tracker kind of aligning with where she's going.
I don't know if this is tracking her or... allows her to track us, but let us flee. I look at Garlene. Do you wish to come with us and trust us, or do you wish to face that?
She's like, you've gotta get me the fuck out of here.
We can do that.
All right. So, are y'all gonna drag her back into? Ampere's hut that's just across the way?
Right now it's probably... Do we want to get trapped in there? Oh, that's the real question.
You do notice that Malanise appears to be like keeping a perimeter, not coming in and directly engaging you, almost as if she's trying to work people up into a frenzy.
Interesting. Interesting.
Save
those rolls, dude.
You fire some rounds out into the stalls and you miss her.
I miss her?
You God miss her, yes.
Damn, she's a
what the fuck?
Holy shit. She can't be Earthio. She's got to be something other than Earthio.
You don't miss her because they go through her. You miss her because she's dodging around and she's able to avoid your shooting.
My eyes go big.
I pick up the party and we leave.
Run like hell.
Go now. It's a witch. She was with a beast from the... I can't remember what the hell it was called. The
insert place here.
No. The creature we found on the docks.
The thing.
It was an abomination. It didn't have a real name. It was the Demurge.
She is the one that summoned the Demurge. Everyone, strike her down. She is summoning the abominations. She is the cause of your blights and your woes.
So she, with the shots fired and with you hollering that, you see the blip on your screen go out a ways. Commotion seems to die down, but then the blip just stays in one place and doesn't appear to move anymore. Ampere
moved away from us?
Then? Yes, when you shot at her and hollered that, it moved away from you and then came to a certain point and just stopped. And Ampere motions for y'all to come inside that he'll seal everything up.
Pi really wants to do a stupid thing right now.
What's your stupid thing?
Kind of want to go after the blip.
You guys think that's a smart move, or?
Oh. I mean, no, but I want to do it now.
I think we all really need to think about how bad we're beat up right now.
Don't touch the stove, it's hot. Don't touch the stove, it's hot.
Ow. Ow.
I mean, none of us could even take one punch without being into trauma.
That's why we gotta roll really, really good.
That's not completely true.
I'm gonna yell out there to him like, hey, get in here, guys. Come on.
All right.
I'll go in.
I'm not happy about it.
Pi wants to follow the flashy light thing, though.
All right, so you all get inside. You bring Garlene in, set her down on the ground, and she's kind of, breaking out in a cold sweat, almost to the point of tears. Her right arm is just extremely stiff.
I kind of... Let me see, and I try to look at what might be wrong with her.
And she, when you say that, she comes like, help, please, please, you've got to help me.
That's what we're trying to do.
One second.
I'm going to ask Ampere if he knows what's going on. Has he seen this before?
So he kind of says like, get her in here. Put her on the couch. Put her on the couch. So I'm guessing y'all pick her up and move her to the couch.
Yeah.
All right. So you observe her chest, rising and falling. She's deathly hot with fever. Her eyes are like skittering around the room. She's like, please, I beg of you, don't turn me over to the Spitalians or the Anabaptists.
That wasn't the plan.
So, Pi, you said you were going to check her out?
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out if I could do anything to help her.
I'm guessing you probably have a knife or something on you. Or somebody has a knife or something on him. Sure.
I have a gun.
You shoot her clothes off of her.
Yeah! I don't have...
So, Ampere produces a knife and hands it to you, Pi. You begin to cut her clothes open, and this like musty smell of just decay kind of comes into the air. You see black streaks that have crisscrossed her arm, almost kind of translucent underneath it. And Ampere's just kind of standing back looking at things, and it's like, that's extraordinary. I've never seen anything like that.
She's got the Rona.
Do you have any medical equipment? I look for any cuts or anything like that. Looking for infection.
So he does not have any kind of medical equipment. And you can definitely tell that she is infected with something.
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out where.
All right, so she... kind of explains to you that this happened about 2 months ago. There was an accident out on one of the secret oil rigs in the Atlantic. I don't know, but we drilled into something and the entire crew was dead. I was able to get out in an escape pod, and the first day it just started as a dot, and then it's just been growing ever since then, and it's getting bigger and bigger with every day. And you hear... go ahead.
I have 4 antidotes, just to let you guys know. Not that I think that would work, but it's a possibility.
So Ampere kind of chimes up in the background. I knew it. I knew that they existed. The oil platforms. That's where Antiquaine gets its fuel from.
I look at him and go, you know you can get a ride out there and go scrapping, right?
He just kind of looks at you dumbfounded, like he's an asshole for not thinking of that sooner. And she kind of continues on a little bit. Perel, he's an idiot. I've always been safe on his island. He never's really meant me any harm. I knew that I could hide out there for a while, and I was hoping this shit would kind of pass, but it just seems to be getting worse. 3 weeks ago, I heard on the market that there's an African woman practicing medicine in the Balm's house. She's got to be an Anubian. I can't get in there with my arm the way it is. If they find out, they'll throw me on the next cart to the House of Atonement. You've got to try to go there and get her out.
What is the House of Atonement, and why would they cart you off if you're trying to get healed?
So give me so she appears to be almost infected with the same shit as was in that creature that was infected with the
like the people and the creatures probably at this point.
Yes. And the House of Atonement, off the top of my head, is usually where they send really, really sick people infected with the demurge, and they obviously never come back. So while this is going on, Ampere runs to the window and, you know, kind of looks around outside, making sure everything's good. And Ampere kind of turns back and says, you know, while y'all were out there dealing with her and your friend was in here resting, I was doing more calculations, you know, from what I've heard. And I think the star and the disc and stuff like that, there's some kind of equipment to where we can get coordinates and convert them into like Dewey Decimal System. You know, I don't really understand what all the numbers and stuff mean like that. I don't have anything that I can match them to figure out what's going on.
I look at him and I go, it's supposed to be a map towards the stream, a way of fixing it all.
Yeah, I need access to the stream in order to look at stuff further. It would just be a hell of a lot easier if I had some kind of map with coordinates and stuff like that.
And I go, something like this?
And his eyes kind of go big and he goes, yes, if these symbols we can convert to numbers, and if we had some kind of map or something like that, then we could pinpoint exactly where it's at. But
pretty sure, well, a map of the city or another piece. Is one more piece.
A map of the world with, you know, coordinates and stuff like that on it. For navigation.
We can always search the market and see what they have. Ship people tend to have coordinate type maps, don't they?
Nobody's going to have a map of the world. That's something that's like from the bygone eras.
Is there not a cluster here?
I think I've heard of something that he's talking about. You're like a GPS, a global positioning system. I mean, I'm digging down into the, you know, scrapping. You hear all kinds of stuff. I've never found one.
And you hear Garlene kind of mumble something a little bit under her breath. Perel, he has a map of the old world. That's what he uses to charm these unsuspecting girls. And then she just kind of passes out.
Do you think we can get out of here and get to the Scrapper's Island? Do you have a way out back, possibly?
And he nods that you can, that you can definitely, you know, get out through the back. He also mentions that, Garlene does not look very well at all.
Yeah, she's gonna freak out like that kid.
We're gonna help you get her to Perel's Island, unless you think you can keep her safe here. And we will attempt to get her healing. But if you get to Perel's Island, make a quick sketch of this with the symbols on it. I'm not going to leave it with you.
Let's bring her back to Perel, and I mean, he cares about her enough to he can help.
He has a map, and then you can use the symbols that you copy from this while we get her an antidote. hopefully you can figure out the location. If you haven't by the time we get back, I will assist you in this.
So you want to drag a woman infected through the streets to this island?
Okay, man.
I mean,
you don't have to sass, all right?
Fine. Stay here and make a quick copy of this. Quickly. And I kind of gesture for him to get some paper. And you're going to stay here with her.
And he nods.
I'm guessing he gets a piece of paper to make a copy.
Yeah, he does. He gets a paper and begins to kind of like sketch it out and stuff. And just, you can see the whole time he's doing this, he's just like, remarkable. Oh my gosh, remarkable.
You gave him the disc?
No, I'm letting him look at it. I've got my gun out still.
I cock my gun as well, yeah.
I don't cock it, I just have it out.
The internet is too dangerous.
It's not that kind of gun.
That's right.
That's the revolver. The last thing this world needs is furries.
Can we really do anything for this girl? Or should we just end it for now?
To see if that woman will come and assist us, at least.
So, Amon would know, since she is from Africa, that the Anubian healers are legendary with this kind of stuff.
The best.
They can put a little tussin on anything and it'll fix it.
I saw a guy literally got his head chopped off. They healed it. Not even joking.
With just a little bit of tussin on it.
Yep.
Okay.
She made him run a lap. Fixed it right up.
But in all seriousness, the Anubians have a way. They like put you under into... Was it? Isn't it like the nether world or something like that, Vadrana? Something like the spirit world or something almost?
You're asking me about lore in this game?
Well, I didn't know if you had read into it a little bit, since that's right. You didn't go the healer route. You went more of the fighter route with them.
Yeah, I know about the ranks and systems of the scroungers. But yeah, like, the only thing I know about the healers is the picture in the book. It's that very nice lady.
Yeah, they can heal.
Scantily clad.
She was scantily clad. They can heal pretty much anything. Badass.
Shit, we could all use a visit to them.
Yeah, she's going to do some sexual healing.
That's right. So let's take...
That's where we get the no-no touches from seeing this lady. That's where we get the no-no.
Well, she could also help us because we're pretty beat up too, so...
Yeah, that we haven't got to that part yet. So nobody will know when that part happens except to the person that it happens to.
What, the sexual healing?
Something along those lines.
They experience, you know, the hallucination.
The rape scene.
Yeah. All right, so let's take a quick little 10 minute AFK bio real quick. We'll pick it back up at 40 after.
I'm kind of scared because it didn't hit the light. after murdering everybody almost in a one shot, at the very end, it couldn't hit me at all, and I kill it.
Okay, I'm back.
I live.
If we all get wiped out in the Genesis, I hope we wake up in the Curse of Shroud campaign.
No. I don't play Curse of Shroud.
I really want to play it again.
That was an amazing game. I really enjoyed that.
Do you ever do repeat campaigns? Because I would do that one again in a heartbeat.
I would. And I would that's one that I would definitely redo, because it's with the way the items shuffle, it would be different every time.
And I don't remember anything, so it would be completely new to me. Other than now I'm going to build a Paladin Hexblade meta OP build.
Oh my fucking god. Yeah, that if you go back and watch our last episode of that, when I'm like doing the outro narration, I get a little choked up while I'm doing it. Because it was so, I mean, the ending to that is just so emotional and epic after everything that happens.
Really good campaign.
Yeah, well, so who all's away? Is everybody back?
I'm here.
I'm here.
This is kind of odd. Give me one second. My grandparents are calling me at 9 o'clock at night. That's odd.
Hello, how's Degenesis going?
Did you kill them all yet?
Yes, kill the party.
Watch your language, son.
Blood for the blood god.
Oh, just a second. Kid wants my attention. I'll be back.
Yeah, so what Pi was talking about earlier with Lord of the Rings. So like when we travel in Degenesis from one city to the other, in Lord of the Rings they have this stupid travel system where like if you roll really poorly, you're just absolutely fucked. And then if you want to get unfucked, you have to go to like a safe haven, which we don't have at level one because we've not done any quests for anybody.
Are you talking about the Adventures of Miller?
Yes. And so you're just like, okay, well, I need to get rid of this, you know, detriment, but like, I can't do that without resting in like a trusted haven or something, whatever it's called.
So I really, really want to run through the starter box for the One Ring. And it's mainly just a bunch of like RP and stuff like that. It's all takes place in the Shire when you play hobbits.
Are you ever gonna do, because that reminds, like if you have a physical box, right? Like it's not Fantasy Grounds.
Yeah, I've got the all the physical material, and then I also converted it all into Fantasy Grounds.
If you ever do like a 3-day weekend like in-person game, let me know, because I would totally fly or drive to participate in that.
Well, I mean, all it would take is some organization, and I would totally do it.
I'd be down for that in a heartbeat.
I know you would, Phil. You're like 5 minutes up the road.
I'm saying if we met somewhere in the middle or whatever.
Yeah, we can
meet at your house. I mean, it doesn't have to be like, because I'm in Ohio, so I have miles, like airline miles. It's not a problem for me to travel. I just need like a heads up on when it's going to be.
My dogs are assholes, so we would probably go to like we would go somewhere.
Like an Airbnb?
Either that, or there's places here in town where I could like rent rooms or something like that to.
Yeah,
to
plentiful around this area. All that kind of stuff is plentiful.
I know there used to be a place in Dayton where you could do D&D games and they'd serve you food and drinks. It was like a restaurant, but they went out of business during COVID, and I'm like, gee, I wonder what happened there.
Yeah.
Felt really bad. It sucked. It looked really cool. I never got to go.
So if you're back, check back in the box.
I've already done that.
Yeah, just let me know if you do an in-person game. I just need about like a 6 months heads up for my PTO.
Yeah, we could we'll definitely have to throw something, because there's I personally haven't done it, but some of the other streamers like Gwydion and stuff like that, they did, was it Denver and Dragons or something like that? They actually rented out a cabin in the up in the mountains and did that, but
that's what I was gonna say.
Well, here's the thing. They all brought their fucking computers and sat around and played on fantasy grounds instead of like rolling the dice and stuff like that, which I use my computer when I go to a convention just because it's easier to keep track of everything, but I want to throw some dice and stuff.
No doubt.
But yeah, once we wrap up this, we'll talk about if everybody does happen to die. Brent, you back?
Yeah, I'm here.
Excellent, excellent, excellent. Brent might be able to hook us up with a cabin in the woods or something, can't you?
I know a few cabins in the woods. Yeah.
Oh, and the best, where Brent lives is where I grew up. It's the most beautiful areas in the United States. It's really, really nice.
As long as it doesn't end up like the movie Cabin in the Woods, then I'll be perfectly fine with it.
If I get killed by a mermaid, I would die happy. And if, what's that actor's name? Actress's name? If Sigourney Weaver shows up, I would let her shoot me in the head.
Yeah. Speaking of that, I actually have the Alien RPG starter box behind me that I need to play eventually, too. Brent, you have a hot mic. There you go. All right. So if memory serves me correctly, y'all were going to go get her help and leave her with, Ampere. Was that correct?
Yep.
All right. So they told you,
can I say something real quick? It's probably getting decently into the evening, right?
Yes, it is. It is late.
You guys think we should sleep?
No. Gotta go fast. It doesn't look like she's going to last much longer. She needs a healer.
And what is our end game with this girl? What are we trying to have her do for us? Like, why are we trying to save her? Just curious. We
get experience for doing this kind of stuff, and that's the only way?
Side quests.
We get experience for doing things, not just murdering things. Murdering isn't so much experience.
We relieve them of their life.
Achieving goals or finding out information is how we get experience to spend into our stats, essentially.
Plus, I will tell you this. I may or may not.
Usually all tie together, so there's that, too.
If a person dies in this and they have information for you later on, not saying that this person does, you will not get that information later on.
Yeah, I got all
Perel
that.
Perel would also probably.
But if we die, none of that makes any damn difference.
That's very true. If you all
I have 3 hit points and then I'm into trauma. I think everybody else here is in pretty much the same spot. I think you got to choose life or death first, else.
I've dealt with trauma before. What you do is you kill yourself, get a fresh character, and then you don't have any trauma anymore.
That's right.
Oh god.
It's the best way to deal with it.
That's right. You go under the knife and have somebody operate on you.
Or you just suffer enough that you travel for like 4 months.
Yeah, that's how I started this with Homeboy travel with us for like 2 months, not doing anything. That doesn't seem very much fun to me.
You do have drugs to help with that if you start getting into your trauma.
Painkillers.
That's right.
Great.
Yeah, I understand all that. But again, I'm just weighing options here.
All right, so you all are headed to the Balm's house. Basalm Balm's? We're going to say Balm's house.
Hey, Malachi, we can all get healed up there.
Yeah, that's true.
Allegedly. Hopefully.
Yeah, as far as you're concerned, sure.
We're killed, Brent.
The problem is that if they've communicated with, the other town that we had visits with, hopefully they don't recognize me. Let's not use my name if you're all okay with that.
All right, sure. So it is nighttime. Um, I need this. Kind of want to. I'm just kidding.
At least we'll die with smiles on our faces.
That's right. All right. So you all approach the bomb's house. It is dark. You see that it does have a guard of sorts at the gate, kind of blowing in his hands to keep himself warm. So you have one of two options that you can do. You can try to jump the wall to sneak in, or somebody could try to fake an injury and bluff their way in. If you try to jump the wall, each person is going to need to pass the check. If you try to bluff your way in, only one person has to bluff the check. But you'll only get one shot at bluffing.
Is it deception?
It is psych, deception to bluff, or agility, stealth to try to scale the wall.
I've got a 6 in deception, and I have a 7 in stealth, so...
I will leave it up to y'all to discuss and figure out what you would like to do.
Oh, shit.
If we're able to sneak in, we still have to probably bluff our way through something. If we can get in through the door by bluffing, that might be a...
We're all pretty injured. I'm not going to get in either. I mean, I'm not going to get in passing those two checks. I can tell you, I'm a 3 and a 2. So, I mean, we need to go with somebody else getting in.
My deception is... Yeah. Oh my god, dude. I totally fucked this up. It says my deception's like 20.
Well, then we know what we're doing then. Good job.
Fell down. My push to talk is control. Is that adding a dice when I click something?
I have no idea. Let me check to see if I've got your original. Oh my goodness gracious.
Nice.
16. All right, I'm ready to deceive, everybody.
We're in.
Wow. I should have your character sheet.
I have the original one. I'll
okay,
fix it.
All right.
All right, I'm back. Sorry. But the dogs were getting something on the fence.
Whoops, only got...
How many are you supposed to have?
4.
All right, 1 second.
You try clearing it out, or?
I got her.
Wait, how'd you do that?
Right click on it and do clear, and then I just added the dice to it.
I might have other things that have that. I'm gonna... Like, this is my athletics, but...
Yeah, that looks...
It should be 6. Okay, so clear...
Yeah, there you go. So you can either drag this dice one at a time over there, or if you left click and grab the dice and then right click, it'll add. Yeah, there you go. You got it.
So but we can either try to deceive our way stealth through it, huh?
Yeah, you can try to jump the wall to gain access, in which case you will each have to pass an agility stealth check. Or one of you can try to bluff your way in with an injury, with a psych deception check.
So we like somebody has an injury in our group and we're trying to get in. Is it really a buff if we're actually injured and we need to get in?
And I'm African?
Yeah, she's injured. She needs to get in. She's African.
I that's true.
Yeah, we're all so fucked up. Yeah,
we're kind of fucked up. Yeah. That's true. That's true.
I mean, Brent's about, Brent's about ready to die.
We are hurt, especially our compatriot, a monitor here.
It's not deception. It's like
telling the truth.
So we're gonna work it at the angle of you are fucked up, so you can get it in there. But how are you going to convince this guy to tell you where this Anubian is in this place?
Shit. Toughness?
So, express the need for this person. How about that?
The easy way would just be for Amon to roll up and say, I need some healing by one of my people.
Yeah, but I have, like, no charisma at all.
You wouldn't need any.
Yeah, they wouldn't expect you to.
Great, like let's that, roll probably. On up.
Show your strength. I'm weak. Look, I'm hurt. Please assist me.
It's a good thing that I fucking blew you.
I seduced the guard.
It's a good thing that I blew y'all up earlier. That way y'all could get in without any questions.
Monitor, I'm better at seducing than you.
And Amon, for the second time in our games, has successfully seduced another guard.
Huzzah!
The only question is, will you follow it up like you did the last time? I think you murdered the last person, if I remember correct.
It was a love-hate relationship.
That's right. It's a strong word. We don't use that here.
That's right. You temporarily relieved him of his life.
We relaxed him.
So I will go up to the is it a clinic?
It's kind of like a... I think they've got a picture. Hang on. Nope, that's... Oh my god, I pulled up the laws. God, I wish I had that in a flyer format to hand out to you again. That would have been good. Have you seen the laws of our town again? Just bear with me one second here, guys. I've got a picture. I just need to find it. Road. Here we go. That's kind of what it looks like there. So the gate is, that's kind of a, doesn't really show you a whole lot with the picture, but.
Wait, isn't that the symbol for,
Yes.
The other group?
The Anabaptist, yes.
But we're, okay. I thought this was supposed to be like an African healing location or whatever.
It is not an African, it is a. Yeah, it's the Anabaptist, which is kind of odd, isn't it? That one of them are in here healing. But yeah, so yeah, you walk up, Amon, I guess, to the guy at the gate guarding the entrance.
Yep.
And he kind of looks at you like, you know, what do you want? It's the middle of the night.
We're severely injured, and I need to see a doctor.
One of your people. We're searching out one of your healers that is here, Monitor. Remember that part.
Yeah, we're looking for an Anubian.
Ah, Mbali, yes. Yeah, she's in here. I mean, where else in Brest would an Anubian be? In the Elephant Temple, perhaps? She's down the hall there, third door on the right, in the steam bath. There's nothing to worry about. She's just in there milking venomous snakes. So he kind of steps aside and opens the gate for you.
Thanks.
He nods as each of you pass by. So you all make your way down. You come to the door. You see kind of steam emanating out from underneath it. What do y'all do?
Go inside.
All right.
Snakes, remember? Milking snakes?
I've seen snakes before. They're not that bad.
How dead are you almost?
So,
what do you think? There's just snakes on the ground?
You know, I mean, anytime yes. I'm milking venomous snakes, I just toss them on the ground and let them roam about.
What was in that one room that ate our companion again?
That was an alligator, and he...
Two alligators.
I think you have a fear of amphibious creatures.
Just don't let
Pi check, fear
check the floor
of in front Degenesis, of you. Degenesis, it's more like.
All right, so you open the door. There's clouds of heavy steam, oils, and stuff like that. You see there's like a pool in the middle of it with a wooden walkway leading around it. You see a silhouette of a person through the fog on the other side. I'm guessing that y'all probably approach her.
And that's why we're here.
As you do so, you see that she is naked, covered in blue and yellow paint from head to toe, holding the skull of a viper to a mason jar, milking it. And you hear her say, without turning around to you, "Why have you come to me?"
We have a lady that's really sick and has this weird black markings on her, and we're trying to figure out if you can help her.
Plus, we all need healing too.
Oh, and that as well, yeah.
So why don't everybody give me instinct perception, instinct intellect legends, please?
What were those? Sorry.
Instinct, perception, intellect, legends.
See, she's naked. I knew it.
What was the other one?
Perception. Second, I'm just looking at notes here. So something that everybody picks up on it, but especially you, Amon, that her accent does not appear African. It appears that she's actually from the south coast of Franca, which is like towards, that's the Talon area where everybody loves pie. And yep. So she says, she nods as she listens to you, Amon, and says, "Does your visit also have something to do with the creature at the fish market? I mean, what did it look like? Did it have patterns and fractals and such?"
Yes. Did it? Yes, yes.
She nods and tell me, how do you know this scrapper? Why are you helping this woman?
Why are we helping her? Whispering to the party.
She's the friend of a friend.
Yeah, she's part of our people that we know.
Known her for years, loved her always.
She's our friend.
She nods at that and then puts the viper back into its container and closes the lid and strides across and puts on a robe, and she says, You do realize that you cannot share your discovery with the Anabaptist here. They will kill this woman and throw you on the next pyre. We cannot bring her here. You must take me to her.
Okay.
Yeah, we can do that. I'd just like to point out that that's not how you milk a snake. That's how you get bit.
She just kind of smiles and dismisses your concern. So she follows you all back to Ampere's shed. And as you all come in, you can definitely tell that he's like disturbed by her presence. He tells you, that she's feverish, that there's no way he's going to be able to concentrate on his different calculations with her here. And Bali moves.
Put that away for now and just calm down. Calm down. You'll be all right.
So he does when you say that, and Bali moves past him, moves over to Garlene, takes and looks at her arm, and she says to everybody to immediately wash your hands right now and do not touch the arm again. She finishes ripping open the rest of the scrapper shirt, and
she's still naked, or
no? She put on a robe.
Okay, just double checking. I didn't remember that part. And I was like, did we just walk through the town with a naked lady?
So she when she rips open the rest of Garlene's shirt, you see that the a stigma is slowly starting to form on her chest. Stigmas like you all saw whenever you were in the woods from those boys that were infested, if y'all remember that. So she says, the spore infestation, it's moving from her arm towards her lung. The poison, it looks to be, and she's kind of looking her over, spreading throughout her body, and it seems to be multiplying. I've never seen anything like this. When the blackness consumes her shoulder and reaches her chest, I'm afraid it will be too late. We must cut her arm off or she will die. And Pierce starts freaking out. You're all crazy. You're just off. Everything's all fucked up. Somebody's on her hill trying to kill us, and now we're in here talking about cutting somebody's fucking arm off.
Well, that's how we're gonna save her, man.
So he's like, "We can't do this here. We need to get out of here. We need to get out of here." And Bali says, "The chronicler, he's right. We need to get out of here to save the gear." Or the girl, I don't have my equipment. I can't cut her arm off. We'll definitely be risking her life if we try to do it here.
Well, where can we go then?
Is there some place safe that we might be able to go to?
Yes.
And she just kind of looks at you like, and where?
The island?
Perel's Island.
Perel's Island.
So she nods at that and says, I will go and get my things. Tell me, do you have means to get over to this island? Do you have a boat or anything?
Actually, we do. We have a boat somewhere.
No, we don't.
How did we get here?
We walked. Or no, we rode wagons here. We boated to one place and then we
wagon to here.
Merchant train here, basically.
Well, I think we have some experience in stealing boats.
We'll find means.
Or
yeah, I mean, I'll pay for transit. We got enough gold to pay for transit.
Or I seem to recall there was somebody that had a boat that somebody was going to go meet last adventure.
Oh, our pirate friends.
Oh, our one buddy that was going to go whaling. Or walrusing or something.
Mud crabbing.
He was down at 9-7 or something like that.
That guy, or there was another That's guy us. As well.
Gilbert?
Oh no, the one African dude. Arms dealer. I don't know how much I actually trust him.
Yep, so you do have a couple leads on some people that might have some boats.
Well, and I'm also thinking we probably could pay somebody at the docks to give us transport.
So so Ampere begins to pack his stuff up. You can definitely tell he's interested in getting the fuck out of this place. And so here, let me share this map with y'all. And so if you see where 18 is, just to the northeast of that, there's a couple of little docks. And so Mbali says that she'll meet you at the docks there. Once you've secured a boat and she gets her things. And she kind of looks to y'all to make sure that y'all understand.
Do you see my arrow?
Oh, sorry.
Like in there.
That's the wrong.
I'm looking at the high res one.
Yep. Yeah. Yeah. Right in that area there. Yeah.
Okay. Sounds like a plan.
So she'll meet us at the boat?
Yeah, she will meet you at the boat. As y'all discussed, y'all have means of getting a boat. So that is obviously what y'all can do. So you have two different places that y'all could go. As you mentioned, you do have your whaler friends who wanted you to meet them at the Flask.
What was her name again?
Her name was Mbali. Give me a second and I will throw it out there for you. So they were at the Flask. And then also, so Frayn had mentioned that, he would be at a place called the West Wind.
Yeah, I think it was the Tusk.
It's the Flask.
Okay. Well, which one do you feel more comfortable doing? The shady arms dealer or more of a local person?
Local person?
Although he might be more keen on assisting.
Oh, but the local person. Yeah, could report us for transporting her with those weird markings.
And Mbali probably.
Yeah, let's roll with a shady arms dealer for sure.
And Solfrain probably might be more keen to keep quiet because Mbali. Because she is. I don't know what she is to your people, Amonitor, but most healers are looked kindly upon.
Yeah, that's fine.
I mean, unless you know something else.
No, I mean, healers are pretty respected, so.
Let's go that route.
But he's an arms dealer, so you gotta take that into account.
Yes. So the West Wind, which is not on there, is it? Oh, nope, 9.
Yep, yeah, it's number 9.
Aha,
yeah.
We were going to 9 all along. So where, I guess we're somewhere in between everything or close to 9 or 6 or 9, somewhere in there maybe.
You're asking where Ampere's shed is?
Yeah.
It doesn't actually say. It gives an indication that it's near like jetties and down towards the water. So it could be like anywhere along the river or the water there.
So are we bringing her with us or
that's for y'all to decide.
I'd be glad to go to the West Wind with somebody and meet up with Safane and try to talk him into this thing. I got to give him his gun back anyway. He helped us before, so he might help us again.
Yeah, I'll go, Brent.
I was going to say, Monitor should probably go. She'd be able to encourage him possibly more using her wiles.
Or her I'd have no charisma.
That's why I said, or her fist.
Yeah, we don't have to go with the lady. Like, she's going to go to the shack and then meet us at the boat.
No, I mean the sick lady.
Let's not drag her around. I don't think that's going to go well.
I'll stay here with her, I guess. Seems best.
Sounds good.
Okay, I'll go with you guys.
So this place is supposed to be close enough to the water that hopefully things don't go sideways.
The water is where that beast came out of, so I don't know if it's, like, safe. Safe, really.
We're going to find out. Me and Ampere here are going to hang out and converse. Because, you know, splitting the party never goes wrong.
And so...
Let's roll.
So let's Twister, Malachi, and Amon, y'all head out to the West Wind then?
Tempur.
All right, so you all get there. You kind of, you see Sofraine kind of in one of the side streets, you know, he's kind of nervously looking about and he sees y'all and kind of waves at you to get you to come over to him.
Yeah, hustle on over there.
My God, it took forever to get rid of those fucking guards, I swear.
You make out all right?
Yeah, I did. And he kind of looks to you, Twister. Do you mind if I get my pistol back from you?
Yeah, hand him his gun back.
He nods at you, thanks you, and kind of stuffs it back into his pants.
We need your help once more. We need a boat.
Okay. A boat I can definitely help you with. But if you remember, there was something that I had asked of y'all before the fucking explosion happened. Do you remember that?
Refresh my memory.
So if y'all remember... was looking for information.
Tell him.
He was wanting to know specifically what somebody was doing in town.
I don't remember that.
Yeah, give me one second. I'm trying to find. Samash was the guy's name. He was the guy inquiring about the disc and stuff for his sheik, if you remember.
So Safane wants to know about this guy?
Yeah, Safane was wanting to know about why he's here trying to buy stuff. Like specifically the disc and the star and stuff. So he mentions, he says, if y'all can go inside and just kind of talk to him real quick, he's inside, figure out what he's wanting. When you come back out, I'll take you straight down to my boat and we can go to wherever it is that you need to go.
All right. I guess I got to do something. He's not going to help us without us helping him.
So he,
All right, I go inside and try to locate this person.
He nods and says, I'll keep an eye outside. You know, to make sure nothing fucked up happens again. And then just come back out and then we'll go to my boat. All right, so...
Do I recognize anybody in there?
You do, Amon and Malachi. Do y'all go inside as well?
Yep.
All right. You go inside. You know, typical bar scene. Tobacco smoke. Just normal bar room type ambiance and stuff like that. You kind of look around. And you see Perel kind of sitting up in a corner, talking to one of the waitresses about how he loves this person. He loves him so much.
Well, shit, I'll go over and reacquaint myself with Perel.
So you walk up and he looks up at you, and that's where we're going to stop for the night. All right. I think it's anything else. So what, the part of the story we're in now, it has, as you all know, you have a shitload of options and stuff, and they're slowly are all starting to come together and tie in. Actually, let me wrap the stream down real quick and then we'll finish talking. All right, everybody. So yeah, there you go. Episode 3, Degenesis, Black Atlantic. We will be back next Sunday for episode 4. Fixing to start getting real. Next episode might even be the fabled naughty episode, with trigger warnings abound and all that kind of stuff. But we'll throw that out there before anything happens. Thanks for stopping in. If you have not done so already, be sure to follow the channel. Join our Discord if you have not done so already. It would help if I could type in the commands we're working. What the fuck is going on here? It appears that the bot is not in the channel. Whatever. Follow the channel. Check out our podcast. We're going to be doing another giveaway again, probably of a One Ring Strotter box, so be sure to check that out. Everything's FSHSchmo on the social medias. Follow all that kind of crap. We'll see everybody later.